Right, okay. Please present your case.
Yes, sir. Aziza Bibi, wife of Mohammad Sharif, 55-year-old, resident of Bahawal Nagar, came through emergency 15 days back with the complaint of pain in epigastrium for one day. Patient was in usual state of health 3 years back when she developed sudden episodes of pain in epigastrium. There were multiple episodes. Pain started suddenly. It was severe in intensity that she had to stop her normal daily routine work. It was associated with vomiting, and there were no aggravating factors, but every time the pain was relieved by taking medication from some local doctor. And there is no history of any weight loss in that time.
No, but
time
that
period.
Was only one day history.
One day history, and there were multiple episodes from 3 years.
Oh, right, okay. And she was taking medicine from
medicines from local
okay.
doctor.
Okay.
Now, 15 days back, before admission to emergency, one day back, she developed pain in epigastrium that was so much severe in intensity that she was referred to Bahawal Victoria Hospital Emergency for further management.
All right.
It was associated with the vomitings, 4 to 5 episodes per day, sometimes containing food particles, and sometimes it was with greenish in color, and sometimes it was watery. It was not associated with any food intake. And she had to stop all her work, which she was doing during that aggravated pain and during that episode of vomiting. There is no history of any weight loss, no history of any loss of appetite, no any jaundice, melena, hematemesis, any regurgitation, water rash, nothing else. No history of headache, fits, systemic inquiry is normal. No any other complaint in systemic inquiry.
So is that all in the history? Or is there any other significant point?
No, sir.
Right.
No history of any fatty meal indigestion, no history of steatorrhea.
So what do you think is the diagnosis?
It was like pain in epigastrium. It was gripping-like sensation. So it could be due to stomach ulceration.
What
it
do you think is the most, what's wrong with this lady? Being a being a clinician, what first disease came in your mind?
Stomach ulceration.
Stomach ulceration for the last 3 years?
3 years.
Why she will be having stomach ulceration for the last 3 years? Is there any history suggestive of gastric disease? What can be that history which can be suggestive of
It would be, other than this patient, it would be associated with hot drinks and any acid food.
Is she taking any medication?
No, sir.
No medication?
No medication.
Is there any medication
no
which
any
can
bony
be related with gastric ulceration?
Yes, NSAIDs. NSAIDs.
Is she
are
on
related.
NSAIDs?
No, sir.
So you think this patient has got stomach ulceration? So technically speaking, what will be your diagnosis?
Sir, I was having a DD. It could be due to acute cholecystitis, having pain in right epigastrium.
So you mean for the last 3 years, she is having
episodes of cholecystitis.
Did you ask about any investigations in the past?
Yes, sir. I asked her, but she did not have any investigation. She was told here that she is having cholelithiasis.
Cholelithiasis?
Yes.
No,
sir.
I mean, did she have any ultrasound before?
No, sir.
So she did not know that she has got ulcerations?
No, sir.
So why, when you know that this patient has got, was told that she has got gallstones, why you are saying that this is ulceration?
Sir, because there is no any fatty meal indigestion.
No, but ultrasound has shown that it is stones.
Yes, sir.
So it's a cholecystitis.
Cholecystitis.
So why you are saying gastric ulceration then?
Sir, because afterwards
if this patient
I
comes to you in your clinic, will you treat it as a patient of a cholecystitis when she has got an ultrasound?
No.
Or
then
you will
I
treat
will
it as a gastric
her,
ulceration?
I will treat her then as a case of cholecystitis.
Okay. Let's start from the beginning. Now, in your opinion, in this patient, the cause of vomiting is actually gallstone disease,
gallstone
and there
disease.
Is an acute episode, and this is responsible
yes, sir.
For
yes,
it.
Sir.
All right, okay.
Because after taking history and after examination, I came to know about ultrasound that she was having.
So why you are hiding it then?
Examination is also important.
So why you are hiding it then?
Yes.
I mean, when you know the diagnosis, then
yes,
you all right, okay. So how will you proceed forward? Now, this is on history.
Yes,
so what
sir.
Are your findings on
examination?
Examination.
Yes, sir. Patient has pallor. Positive.
Okay.
And she is markedly anemic.
Okay.
No any jaundice, normal vitals, But on examination of abdomen, there is a mass globular in shape extending from right in the area of right hypochondrium, epigastrium and umbilical region, globular
it's
in
a
shape.
Big mass.
Yes, sir. 7 into 12 centimeter, well-defined margins, and it is moving with respiration.
Okay. So what is that mass? From where it is arising?
I think it is like arising from gallbladder.
Is it gallbladder?
Yes.
So
sir.
What are the points which are in favor that it is arising from gallbladder?
It is globular in shape,
okay.
Moving with respiration.
Okay.
It is dull on percussion.
Okay.
Well-defined margins.
Okay. So now what is your diagnosis? Anything else?
Yes.
Anything else on the examination which is important?
No any ascites, okay. Normal percussion. No.
So any other significant positive or negative findings?
No, sir.
No. All right. Is spleen enlarged?
No, sir.
Spleen is not enlarged.
Not enlarged.
So because I was wondering that why she's having anemia. Because
yes.
Anemia, so we have to explain
yes.
why. So what is your explanation that this patient has anemia?
I asked about the defecation and color of stool. She didn't notice any. I had a suspicion there could be
okay.
any.
Okay, so on this history or in this clinical examination, what do you think is your diagnosis now?
She had a severe episode of pain, so I think there would be mucosal. Or
okay,
empyema at that time, which may
okay.
have.
What is the difference between mucosal and empyema clinically?
Yes, sir. Mucosal, empyema. When patient has empyema, there is patient is toxic, having increased, having tachycardia,
and on
fever.
Clinical examination,
it is tender.
Okay.
It is tender, and having
mucosal?
Signs of mucosal has just there are no any signs of inflammation.
Why mucosal forms?
Because there is continuous mucus production and a stone gets impacted in the heartwand pouch or neck of the gallbladder, and the mucus which is being secreted in the from the mucosa of the gallbladder, it doesn't come into the CBD. So that got.
So what happens to the bile? Because when you open a mucosal,
yes, sir.
It is a white colored.
White
thing.
Color.
So
bile doesn't
does bile
go.
Go?
Bile goes directly from CBD to duodenum.
So it is only the mucus or any other factor which is responsible for edema of the gallbladder?
I don't have any idea.
Okay. So lymphatics has any role in it or not?
Yes, lymphatics have, but it has.
Okay.
I think
so,
it knows.
Okay,
it
fine.
Has no.
Now in this patient, now we have got a history, we have done the examination, and you think that this patient has. So she has a empyema or mucosal? Right now, mucosal or empyema?
Right now, mucosal, because
mucosal?
Patient is having normal vitals,
okay.
And she.
Why she was having vomiting? So profuse vomiting.
I think I had a suspicion that there would be, if it there is gollilithiasis, there would be some stones passing through the pancreatic duct, which will be causing pancreatitis, and there would be due to increased.
Do you think this is, so this patient has pancreatitis, you think?
Yes, sir. I had an idea that she would be having pancreatitis because it was severe pain in epigastrium that was reducing.
Why not some simple diagnosis? Why not gastritis associated with cholecystitis and responsible for?
Yes, it could be.
So why to think of something very difficult then? So anyways, but this we have to consider in our mind before doing a surgery. After all, why
yes.
so much vomiting?
Well,
okay,
yes.
And we'll come to that point later on. Okay, how will you proceed forward in managing this patient? We know the history, we
yes,
know the
sir.
Clinical examination. We think this patient has got empyema, which is not resolved on antibiotics.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So what's next?
I would have, regarding her age, pre-anesthesia assessment of the patient.
Okay. Her hemoglobin is 9.
9.
What else you want?
Chest x-ray.
Chest x-ray is normal.
ECG.
Is normal.
And ECG, and then we'll proceed for surgery. But yes. Before that, I would like to have CT scan of this patient.
Why?
To know the status of the pancreas as well and pancreatic duct and CBD.
So did you do
well.
Any other test which could tell you about the pancreas? Why
yes,
you are
sir. Serum amylase and lipase.
So they are normal.
Then I think we should proceed for.
And what do you do with the vomiting?
Yes, sir.
Would you like to do a gastroscopy before doing?
Yes, sir.
Because
yes,
there
sir.
May be
there may
be some
other
cause
pathology.
In the stomach
yes,
because.
Sir.
I remember your initial diagnosis was gastric ulceration.
Yes, sir.
So what we have done for that?
So I would like to have a gastroscopy and to see in the stomach as well as in the duodenum.
Then
because
do
she has she had multiple episodes
okay.
of vomiting.
So if, for example, gastroscopy shows just the gastritis, and there is no evidence of pancreatitis, what next?
What next? Then cholecystectomy.
Okay.
Followed by...
Would you like to blood transfuse blood because her hemoglobin is 8 or...
No.
Would you like to further investigate?
Hemoglobin is not an indication for BT.
Alright. Okay. Would you like to further investigate?
Yes, sir.
Why
I would like to have follow-up gastroscopy of this patient.
No, no, but why she had anemia on the first place?
Yes, sir.
Mm. What about her nutrition? Did she have a good nutrition last 6 months or?
Yes, sir. She was eating normally.
So would you like to do, what operation would you like to do?
Laparoscopic cholecystectomy.
Okay. So you just open, you put the port and you found gallbladder is hugely distended.
Yes, sir.
And there are, omentum is stuck with that and colon is also stuck with that and you carefully started. And then you find difficulty in dissection in Keller's triangle. What will you do?
I will go for open. I will convert the laparoscopy into open.
What is the criteria of converting a laparoscopic procedure into an open procedure? When you are
facing difficulty, when you are not
what
able
is that?
To...
Objectively, please. What
yes,
is
sir.
That difficulty?
When you cannot appreciate the boundaries of the Keller's triangle as omentum is adherent to the gallbladder.
But you can remove the appendix and you can
yes,
further
sir.
Dissect it. But what is the cutoff point? That at this point you decide that no, I have
no,
to convert into open.
I don't know.
No?
No.
Okay. These are the points. Okay. Fine. So you have done that operation. And what are the possible complications which can occur in this patient?
Yes. Patient had empyema. So there could be afterwards abscess formation. Abscess in some collection. There can be some collection.
Okay. On the fourth post-operative day, this patient develops fever,
yes,
right?
Sir.
And patient becomes toxic.
Yes, sir.
And mild tinge of jaundice.
How
will you further manage that?
Manage. I would like to have her CBC and LFTs.
CBC is 18,000.
Okay. And I would like to have LFTs.
LFT shows bilirubin 2.3 and SGOT, SGPT is double than the normal.
And
alkaline phosphatase is normal.
Normal. Then it could be hepatic jaundice. But I would like to have ultrasound along with that.
Ultrasound shows some collection in the Rutherford-Morrison pouch.
I would go for ultrasound guided respiration.
Alright.
Of that collection.
Alright. Okay. Thank you very much. Now, let's rate it. What is your feedback about your performance?
I still need improvement.
So what was the area where you were lacking?
I couldn't make the diagnosis with the history that the patient was giving. 3 years having only pain in epigastrium, not radiating to right hypochondrium or to the back. Only pain in epigastrium.
If you would have been examiner, what would have been coming in your mind when listening this viva?
Theek
hai, pass kar dun, na pass karun. What do you think would be coming in your mind?
I need improvement.
So, if you are an examiner, will you
yes,
pass
sir.
Yourself?
No.
Okay, right. What's your feedback? You can use this mic.
So, I think she was okay. Not up to that passing
credit. So, what were the areas where she lacked?
So, she lacked in the certainty of her diagnosis.
Okay.
She switched to another diagnosis when you convinced her that why not acute cholecystitis? Because first she stuck to
will
gastric
ulcers. Will you pass her or not?
Difficult for me to say.
Okay. What's your feedback?
Yes, sir. There was clear-cut treatment history, mm-hmm. but she was toward the medical side than to the surgical side and as far as diagnosis is concerned. So it is my view that 50%.
Yeah. So 50% is not past person. Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Sidra?
परिहा वॉज गुड इन द सेंस के इन्होंने बातों को बहुत मतलब हिस्ट्री अच्छी ली हुई थी सिंपल रखा हुआ था लेकिन ये कि अपने डायग्नोसिस में कन्फ्यूज़ हो गई तो बस उसके बाद से फिर थोड़ा कन्फ्यूज़ ही रही तो इस वजह से जब तक आपका डायग्नोसिस डेफिनेटिव नहीं है तब आपके माइंड में एक डेफिनेटिव डायग्नोसिस नहीं इसलिए आप आगे भी थोड़ा कन्फ्यूज़ ही थी तो वो ये चीज़ जो है ना ये हर जगह नज़र आ रही थी तो इसलिए वैसे अदरवाइज हिस्ट्री अच्छी थी उनकी.
Yeah, I think you were on the right track, in my opinion. Your presentation was pleasant. That's also very important. When you are presenting, you should be having a pleasant impression. You were pleasant. You looked confident. And but see, examiner already knows that this patient, bitanik another shor na bachhe na, control kare. Examiner already knows that this patient has got empyema gallbladder. Examiner already had examined this patient, has made a checklist, knows all the physical findings, knows everything, what treatment you got. Now, whatever examiner knows, if you tell him or her, he will be very happy.
Right.
Now, what you were telling to the examiner was not what examiner knows.
Right.
And when you know that this patient had a big mass, so in the history, you should have presented a history in such a way that at the end of the history, examiner would have no confusion.
Right.
Right? Like you could just present this history in such a way, this patient, the history date backs to 3 years,
mm-hmm.
when she had this. Now she presented with an acute pain over here. See, focus on the pain.
Yes, sir.
Aapko dard hota tha? Nahin, jab aap aayin thi idhar, jab itha aave aave dard hoti na aayu mein. So she came with the pain. Why don't you focus on the pain instead of vomiting? So if someone knows that a lady had a 3 years history of pain epigastrium and now she came with an acute pain, along with that pain there is vomiting. Now what will come in examiner's mind? Gallbladder disease. Instead of just focusing on the vomiting, then the differential diagnosis is totally opposite.
Right.
So you offered an diagnosis on history which is totally contrary to that of the actual diagnosis. So wahan se phir aap. So your history should generate the diagnosis.
Yeah, right.
And you have already done the examination. You have the bigger picture in your mind, right? So it is not in isolation that you are being examined. You are examined in totality. So if your history would have been such that when examiner would have asked you, okay, what is wrong with this patient? So you could say, well, this patient, in my opinion, is a patient of gallstones and had repeated attacks, but now admitted with an acute attack. And I have already examined the patient. Patient has got a huge mass as well. And she told me it was very tender, but now it has better. Probably she is getting antibiotics. And I also, and there is no shame in asking that. I asked from her, what is your investigations?
Right.
In your own practice, in your work in ward, you normally ask from, aapne pehle test to nahi karwaye. So there is no shame in it. There is no secret in it. So I have asked from the patient. She says that I have got.
Is it allowed in exam?
It is must in the exam. Asking previous, why not to ask him? You have to make a diagnosis. It is you are not expected to make a miracle or a prophecy. You are expected to make a diagnosis from available data. Agar patient kehta hai ji maine pehle muh se muayana karaya hua hai, unhone kaha tha ki aapka ulcer hai, so you may ask for the evidence, but you take patient's words as an evidence.
Right.
To agar aap ye kehti to examiner darmiyan mein soye na hota bilkul bhi. Aur fir wo aage move karta rehta. To always try to make the diagnosis which is in examiner's mind,
right?
And then anemia was one area where you could show your brilliance, because this is something different. You could say yes, and there is no need to just say this. I know why there is anemia. Why you say, sir? I'm sorry, I don't know it. I have taken the history of nutritional history. Probably for last 3 months, her diet is not very well. But there is no history of melena. There is no history of scars. This should have been mentioned in the history.
Right.
There is no blue scar, no evidence of bleeding somewhere in the body. Aapne menstrual history bilkul nahi batai.
Sir, but I took that.
Nahi, but yes. It's not enough to just love someone. You have to,
but in other words, I would like well. To add some family history is important.
Dekho, dekho, beta, baat ye na, ki we are trying to find out why she is anemia. So if you would have said all those things, so examiner knows that she has worked it out. And they said, why is anemia? I'm sorry, I don't know what's anemia.
Right,
but maybe, you know, when that acute phase is over, I would like to do her colonoscopy or occult blood in the occult blood. And I would like to know why there is anemia. But at the moment, I think it is nutritional.
Right.
So you can just say iron deficiency. You can argue de sakti thi.
Right,
so is tarike se aap proceed karenge, to examiner kabhi soye nahi kar. But I think you are on a right track. And inshallah, ye to they are little miser. So you need only little bit of polishing.
Right,
little more confident. And speak a little more louder.
Right, sir.
Right, little more louder. So well done.
Thank you.